You must be Margot. I'm Marion Clark. I've been taking care of the house and your father these past few days. I'm sorry to have called you in such a state of urgency, but the situation here has become difficult. You must be Blake.
Afternoon, Miss.
Clark, your grandfather told me a lot about you before he... Well, you'd best come up. See for yourself. This room is for you, Blake. It's a very special room. I hope you'll like it. Fit for a king. And if you'll come with me, Miss Clement, your room is just down the hall.
This will do me nicely, I should think.
There are spare blankets and sheets in the wardrobe if you need them.
What have you found there?
Some old toy. Just came out of nowhere.
Do you like it, Blake? You can have it if you want.
Just leave it alone, Blake. It looks filthy. So, what do you think? Spooky enough for you?
No, actually. It's rather peaceful. Spectacular, even. I think I'm going to love it here.
Well, it's certainly more space than your father would have left us with. When I was a girl, I was terrified of staying here. All these old rooms, long dark halls, dusty furniture. Now it all just appears quite miserable. Empty and soulless. Somewhere I can call home. Vile thing, isn't he?
Mum.
He was a ghastly looking man. He's like some waxwork that should be displayed in the Chamber of Horrors. No wonder they've kept him in the attic all this time.
You shouldn't do that here.
I shouldn't. Well, it is what it is. Free house, free place to stay. Till the old bastard croaks.
Do you have to be so unkind? I wonder if he can hear us.
Oh, I hope to God he can. Aubrey wasn't a pleasant man, you know. He was a recluse, very secretive, with macabre interests. Drove my mother to the brink of madness.
He was always kind to me.
Oh, you were so young you wouldn't remember.
I remember it well, spending time with him. It's all coming back to me now I'm here.
Unusual for your grandfather.
I'm going to take a look around.
Off you go, then. Oh. Oh. That was nice.
I thought you weren't going to do that here.
Oh, drop it, I'm just settling in.
That was Elgar.
This can be a music room if you like. I'll keep my nose out. Perfect place for your studies.
Found that in the library. Last ones of Grandad. Me and him together.
I feel like we've been sent off, Blake. Sent away to be forgotten. Nobody's problem. I can waste away out here without interruption. Only you to witness it. I called your dad earlier.
Really?
He's going to come by for a visit. Tomorrow, I think. So let's pretend that we love it here, and we're living like kings, and we're bloody well better off without him. You'll do that for me?
We're here for Grandad. He knows that.
Yes, but leaving you with me is difficult for him, isn't it?
I can look after myself just fine. I've looked after you when I've had to, haven't I?
Better than anyone else ever did.
Go to bed, Mum.
No, thanks. I think I'll sit here a while. Watch the flames.
Yeah!
chair. How did it get out there?
Mum?
Open the bloody door, Margot. It's cold out here.
Hold on.
What took you so long? It's bitter out there.
You found us then?
Eventually. You really are on the absolute arse end of nowhere. Not a single house or car for miles.
It's what a private drive is, Gordon. Dad valued his seclusion from the rest of the world.
Perfect dwelling for you, then, eh? Where's Blake?
Morning, Dad.
Ha! Everything going okay here, then, Blake?
Fine.
Good lad. You're going to offer me a cup of tea, then, Margot?
Blake, get the kettle on.
Have you seen my violin? It's not in the case.
You were playing it yesterday.
Ah!
Hello? Hello? Who's out here?
Head buried in those books forever.
Oh, it's what he likes. Just leave him be.
How's he going to make a life for himself all the way out here?
It's not for you to decide, Gordon. He makes his own choices.
You leave him no choice. He knows how much you depend on him.
I'll just leave them on the side.
Thank you, Brig.
We are alone here, aren't we? I mean, there's nobody else living on the grounds.
Just us? Why?
Nothing. Just wanted to be sure.
Give us a moment, Blake.
Even when I'm sure I'm alone, I suspect he might be spying from me.
Blake? Let's have a word.
It doesn't get any easier watching him leave. We managed decades of ups and downs, all of that just to be left here. Not a thing to show for it.
You've got me. It's more than he has.
Can you believe he once asked me to marry him?
What did you say to that?
It was the wrong time. He asked me just after you were born. He loves you dearly. But if he'd felt the same about me, well, I waited. But he never asked again.
You know why that was. Why don't you give it a rest, Mum? Just for tonight.
It's just easier to drink and allow you to hate me.
I don't hate you. I'm just asking you to stop for one night.
If it was as easy as just stopping, don't you think I'd have done that? Locked up that basement and poured every bottle down the sink.
And why don't you?
Because then I'd have to find more. And what a bloody pain that would be out here.
You said you'd carry on like this.
It must be exhausting being right about fucking everything.
Must be very easy being so fucking predictable.
Oh, just leave it, Blake. I've heard it enough times.
And when will you listen?
Christ, you sound just like your dad.
I'm nothing like my dad. I've stood by you. I've done everything I can and it's still not enough. Maybe you are a lost cause.
The
thing about family, Blake, is you're stuck with them. We can't hide our mistakes from family, and we can't all be perfect. So one day, Blake, I'm going to get to see you make the wrong choices. And then I'll be the one who gets to judge.
I'm not judging. I'm just asking for my mum back.
Doesn't fully understand me. So I said goodbye, leaving him to it for now. I have a plan now. If I leave my door open, perhaps even play music to entice him in, I think the boy might gain the confidence to enter Clement Hall.
And then he will have to talk to me. I could teach him to communicate. He could be my next project. My next obsession. Something to pry me away from these terrible studies of evil things.
Help us, Blake! Help us! Help us! Help us!
I came as soon as I could.
I've been up most of the night.
I'm sorry.
I thought you said he wasn't well enough to walk.
Something had him agitated.
Bless you, Blake. He doesn't know what he's doing. He's totally lost in a place he's spent most of his life. It's a lot to contend with. Did he say much while he was up? You said on the telephone he was speaking.
Just nonsense.
What nonsense?
Nothing I could understand out of context.
You're quite sure?
Yes.
How long's he been doing that with his hand?
Since we dragged him back into bed. He hasn't stopped.
It's as if he's writing.
He can't write. It's just a muscle spasm. He has no control over it.
Miss Clark, wait.
Yes, dear?
The previous carer, you said that she left. You said that she couldn't stand being here. That she was frightened?
Yes.
Perhaps you have a telephone number or an address I could write to her.
Oh, no, she won't come back here, I can assure you.
The room I'm staying in, that was her room, wasn't it?
Why do you ask?
The wardrobe is still full of her clothes and other possessions. Why would she leave without taking her belongings? Unless her leaving was unexpected, even to her.
She didn't leave. Not exactly.
What do you mean by that?
Her name was Anne Harper. When I came by for my weekly check-in, Anne had simply gone without a trace. Nobody's heard from her. She took nothing. It was only her and Aubrey alone in this house, and we've not the faintest idea what might have happened. That's the honest truth. All we know is she's gone.
And you didn't think to mention this?
Would you have stayed, knowing the previous occupant had disappeared into thin air? I didn't think so. My job is to ensure Mr. Clement is looked after. So I saw to it he had somebody here to care for him. Sorry I had to be dishonest. I'll pray you are both still here when I return next week.
What if he's not ill?
Of course he's ill, Blake.
No, I mean, what if it isn't dementia? What if it's something unexplained? Something in this house that's doing that to him? I've seen some weird things here.
Oh, Blake.
Something drove his carer to leave without warning. What was so awful that she would leave an elderly man like that?
I don't know. Maybe she's just an unreliable old cow.
Do you know the things he used to do? What he used to spend his days researching? I've been listening to his tapes, reading his notes.
Don't let your imagination turn this into something else, Blake.
I'm not.
I know it's hard and unpleasant for you seeing your grandfather the way he is. If I'd known the state he was in, maybe I wouldn't have brought you here. Don't torment yourself looking for logic in his madness. Aubrey isn't there anymore. He's just a shell. Oh, Blake, wait!
Mum! Look.
But what exactly?
He drew that.
Dad drew it?
You know, I don't think he's as brain dead as Miss Clark wants us to believe.
These are scribbles, Blake.
Maybe. But the same scribbles, again and again and again? He just keeps going.
It's just lines.
But how can he do them the same? It's an exact floor plan of Clement Hall. How can you explain that?
He knows this place like the back of his hand.
This is the basement?
That is, yes.
And this room?
There isn't another room. I've been down there. It's just a wine cellar.
Not according to Grandad. You went down there by yourself?
I'm not going in again.
There are spiders the size of dinner plates. Stop it.
I'll be out in a minute.
Where were you when I needed you?
I'm here. Always have been.
Blake?
It's human bones.
The basement room. It really was down there.
You have to see what he did, Mum. You have to see what happened in this house. They killed that boy.
Boy? The thing hardly looked human.
Perhaps they did that to him.
Oh, stop it, Harold. He's sick.
I've seen him, you know. Jacob is his name. He's been in this house with us since we got here. I think Aubrey's being punished. Jacob is still here, watching over him until he's dead. We should bury the bones. Isn't that what you do when there's something evil in the house? You take it out and you put it to rest.
I just want the thing out of the house.
So we're leaving?
You are.
I'm not going anywhere without you.
I don't know what's happening in this house, Blake.
You can't just keep pushing everyone away.
This isn't about me.
You have to face the problem. You can't do it alone.
Blake.
Mum, I said I'd stay and help.
I don't want your help. I brought you into a nightmare with me. I've been so selfish. I didn't spare a thought for you. It's just... without your father, I didn't want to be here on my own. I couldn't face it. So I've dragged you into this darkness with me. I am sorry, Blake. You can't stay here. In this place, this twisted place. I'm losing my mind.
Even with all the cruel things about this house... I couldn't be anywhere else, Mum. We'll bury the bones.
gradually I notice. Small occurrences at first. Things will move. Doors will open. Could have been the wind, maybe. But at night, it got worse. It was as though, because it was harder to see, the thing in this house, he would play bigger games with me. Every time I tried to sleep, the chair would start to rock. That's how I knew it was watching me. And the more it watches, the more of it you begin to see for yourself. It was there all along, plain as day before my eyes. First, just a glimpse of a figure, shape, turning the room cold from a dark corner. But then, I will see more. A hand, a body. And then, a face. That awful, horrifying face. Once I've seen it, I realize it wasn't the first time. Just my mind, hidden from my eyes, it was there. It was always there.
Jacob. That's his name.
Jacob. That's what he called himself.
The boy was murdered here.
So you have seen him already?
Only glimpses.
No glimpses. He can't just be glimpsed. He occupies this house for anyone to see. Anyone who dares to look. He occupies Aubrey. Somehow, he and Jacob are one. And now that Aubrey is dying, it's after anything that's living. Anything that's living is not safe in this house. I hear them say that. I hear them talking, crouching.
Well, he hasn't spoken since we've been here.
He talks. Maybe it's no longer him, but he talks.
Clearly, you've had a fright.
I can prove it to you. You don't have to believe me. I'll show you. Tell them what you said to me. I know you can speak. I have heard it with my own ears. Now talk, damn you! Speak! I'm not crazy. If you want to speak, you may as well be deaf.
She knows what she's doing. Let her talk to me!
She's gonna kill him!
All right, that's enough.
We can die.
What did you say?
We can die. Not yet.
Why?
Not my time. Too young. Can't have this old body no longer.
Tell them what you told me. Tell them your name.
Jacob.
Your name's Aubrey.
Aubrey almost gone. I keep us alive.
Why?
Till she can find us a new one.
Who?
My mummy, I miss her. I said, don't leave. But she said you'd suspect. She said it takes time.
Time? For what?
For the boy to be ready. Aubrey told her, you're the one. She got you to come here. To help me.
Who got us to come here?
Miss Clark.
Who is Miss Clark? The nurse they sent from your agency to replace you. She comes by every week.
I'm not from an agency. It's just my sister and me.